Let's have it.
Arthur?
Gentlemen, as most of you now know, you two over Cuba Sunday morning took a series of disturbing photographs. Our analysis at NPIC indicates that the Soviet Union has followed up its conventional weapons buildup in Cuba with the introduction of surface-to-surface medium-range ballistic missiles, or MRBMs. Our official estimate at this time is that this missile system is the SS-4 Sandal. We do not believe that the missiles are as yet operational. Ironbark reports that the SS-4 can deliver a 3-megaton nuclear weapon 1,000 miles. So far, we've identified 32 missiles serviced by about 3,400 men, undoubtedly all Soviet personnel. Our cities and military installations in the southeast, as far north as Washington, D.C., are in range of these weapons, and in the event of a launch, would have only 5 minutes of warning.
5 minutes, gentlemen.
In those 5 minutes, they could kill 80 million Americans and destroy a significant percentage of our bomber bases, degrading our retaliatory options. The Joint Chiefs' consensus, Mr. President, is that this signals a major doctrinal shift in Soviet thinking to a first strike policy. It is a massively destabilizing move. We need more U-2 coverage.
Gentlemen, I want first reactions here. Assuming for the moment that Khrushchev has not gone off the deep end and intends to start World War III, what are we looking at?
Well, Mr. President, I believe my team is in agreement. If we permit the introduction of nuclear missiles to a Soviet satellite nation in our hemisphere, the diplomatic consequences will be too terrible to contemplate. The Russians are trying to show the world they can do whatever they want, wherever they want, and we're powerless to stop them. If they succeed...
It'll be Munich all over again.
Yes. Appeasement only makes the aggressor more aggressive. And the Soviets will be emboldened to push us even harder. Now, we must remove the missiles one way or another. Now, it seems to me the options are either some combination of international pressure and action on our part till they give in, or we hit them, an airstrike.
Bob?
We've worked up several military scenarios. Before I ask General Taylor to take us through the various options, I'd like for us to adopt a rule. If we decide to strike, we must agree now to do it before the missiles become operational. Because once they are, I don't think we can guarantee getting them all before at least some of them are launched.
Well, it's clear we cannot permit Soviet nuclear missiles in Cuba. We have to get those missiles out.
Mr. President, our deliberations have led us to the conclusion that a blockade of offensive weapons to Cuba is our best option. A strong showing of support from the Organization of American States would give us an umbrella of legitimacy.
A blockade is technically an act of war. Therefore, we recommend calling the action a quarantine.
Let's hope that translates into Russian the way we want it to.
There are between 20 and 30 Soviet ships underway to Cuba at this time. 800 miles out, the Navy will stop them, board, and any vessels containing weapons will be turned back. A quarantine prevents any more missiles from reaching Cuba, but it doesn't remove the missiles already there. It gives the Soviets a chance to pull back without a war. If they refuse to remove the missiles, we retain the option to strike and invade.
A sneak attack would be counter to what the United States stands for. Leaves us no room for maneuver, and the inevitable Soviet response would force us into a war.
Mr. President, there are still those of us who believe we should proceed with the strikes. Sir, with the blockade, we lose strategic surprise, and we also run the risks of the Soviets launching a first strike against us if they decide they have to use the missiles or lose them.
So quarantined or airstrike? I've not yet made my final decision. I'll be asking the networks for airtime on Monday night. We'll announce our course of action then. Ted, I want you to get working on speeches for both quarantine and airstrike. Well, thank you for all your advice, gentlemen.